And if not a single human being praise him, yet it will not diminish him. He is the same. Whether you say Allahu Akbar 1,000 times or 1,000,000 times, it will not make Allah greater. Or if you don't say Allahu Akbar also, it will not make him less. He is the greatest, he'll remain the greatest. And Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Anfal chapter number 8, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't require the human beings. It is we who required him. It is the human beings who require him, and he is worthy of all praises. The Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not require his creation. It is the creation who require Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he is worthy of all praises. So the question is, why does he require us to praise him? The reason is, it is for our own benefit. Because it is a human tendency that if we praise a person, if a person is famous, we tend to follow his advice. For example, if your mother is suffering from a heart problem, and there are two options, the one option who you have is the best doctor in the world, number one, very famous, everyone knows him, number one. Other person is just a plain MBBS doctor, and you have the option of going to any of them. Both are giving free treatment. Who will you go to? But naturally, you go to the one who is very famous, number one in the world, the heart specialist. And whatever advice he gives you, because he's world famous and you even acknowledge him to be the greatest amongst all the doctors, you will follow his advice. That is the reason when we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and call him, he's the greatest, he's the most merciful, he's the most kind. The moment we praise him, whatever advice he has given us in the last and final revelation, the glorious Quran, or whatever advice he has given us through his messengers, and the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we will follow it. So the reason we praise him is not for the benefit of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He does not require praises. It is for our own benefit. The moment we praise him, oh, he's the greatest, he's the most wise. Okay, he's telling you not to have alcohol, then you stop having alcohol. The moment you agree that he's the most wise, he's the greatest, he's the most merciful, immediately whatever advice he gives you, it is human tendency, we follow the advice of the person who's the greatest. So that's the reason we praise him, for our own benefit. And that's the reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in Surah Taha, chapter number 20, verse number 14, that verily, I am Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I am Allah, and there's no God besides me. So remember me regularly and offer prayer regularly. Allah is guiding that offer prayer regularly, because today in the world there are so many evils, so many distractions, we tend to deviate. This salah is a sort of programming towards righteousness. This form of worship is a programming towards righteousness. We are getting programmed. As a doctor says that for a healthy body, you require minimum 3 meals a day. So for a pure soul, for a healthy soul, you require minimum 5 times salah. So all forms of worship are benefit for us. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 183, that fasting has been prescribed to you as it was prescribed to those who came before you, so that you may learn self-restraint. Why do we fast? So that we learn self-restraint. And today, the psychologists tell us that if you can control your hunger, you can control almost all your desire. So when we fast, we abstain from food, drink, from dawn to sunset. If we can control our hunger, we can control almost all your desires. So by fasting, we are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But who's benefiting? Not Allah. We are benefiting. We are learning to control our desires. And Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Maida, chapter number 5, verse number 90, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, O you who believe, innamal khamru wal maisuru, most certainly intoxicants and gambling, wal anzabu wal azlamu, dedication of stones, divination of arrows, rushtum min amali shaitan, these are Satan's handiwork, fashtanibul lakum tuflihun, abstain from this handiwork that you may prosper. Here we are being guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that, O you believe, most certainly intoxicants, gambling, dedication of stones, that idol worship, divination of arrows, that is fortune telling, these are Satan's handiwork, abstain from it that you may prosper. And Allah says in the next verse, in Surah Maida, chapter number 5, verse number 91, that Satan, he creates enmity and hatred between the human beings through intoxicants and gambling. And this takes you away from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah is guiding you. When you offer salah or when you read the Quran, that's a form of worship. When you offer salah, form of worship, you are getting guided. That stay away from intoxicants, from gambling. It is the Satan who uses this to create enmity between the human beings. And this will take you away from remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All forms of worship, any act, any commandment that you follow of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a form of worship. Any commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a human being follows, it's a form of worship, as long as you do it in the right way. There are two things, there are two criteria required. Number one is that you should do it only for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and not for your own glorification or praising your own self. Any act you do, you should do it for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever Allah commands you, do it for His pleasure, not for glorification, not for praise, not for becoming famous. Criteria number one. Criteria number two, that it should be done the way Allah and His Messenger has commanded you. Whatever Allah has asked you, do it the way Allah has asked you to do or the way His Messenger has asked you to do. If you do it in any other way, that's not called worship. So do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, follow His commandments and the commandment of the Prophet, but the way Allah and His Prophet have told you. If you do it any other way, then it is not correct. And it's mentioned in the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Sahih Muslim, volume number 2, hadith number 1885, where the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the worst of all the affairs is innovation in the religion, innovation in deen. It is a curse, and the innovation in the deen will take you to hellfire. Means the worst of all the affairs is bidah in deen, innovation in deen, and this is a curse and will take you towards hellfire. So whatever you do, worship. There's a general rule that all types of worship is prohibited except the type which is mentioned in the Quran and the Sahih Hadith. The type which has been mentioned by Allah and His Rasul. Any other type of worship is prohibited. It is forbidden except that type of worship which has been described in the Quran and described in the Sahih Hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So further, if we analyze that the purpose of the creation of the human being is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we worship him, we benefit. It helps us. And there's a misconception that Islam is a new religion which came into existence 1400 years ago. And Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the founder of this religion of Islam. In fact, Islam is there since time immemorial, since man set foot on this earth. And Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is not the founder of this religion. He is the last and final messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There were several messengers that came, as Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Fatir, chapter 35, verse 24, وَإِمْ مِنْ أُمَّةٍ إِلَّا خَلَافِيَا نَزِيرٍ. There is not a nation or a type whom we have not sent a warner or a guide. Allah says in Surah Rod, chapter number 13, verse number 7, وَلِكُلِّ قَوْمٍ هَادٍ. And to every people has a warner been sent. There are more than 25 messengers mentioned by name in the Quran. Adam, Noah, Abraham, Moses, Jesus, Muhammad, peace be upon them all. All of them were messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and all of them, they were Muslims. Muslim is a person who submits